Good morning students, welcome to social science class of 8th grade. Today we will learn history 4th chapter, ancient civilizations of the world. In this chapter you learn the great civilizations of the world, that is Egypt, Mesopotamia and China. Next, art, architecture and lifestyle of different civilizations. First one, Egyptian civilization. The country is located in the northeastern corner of Africa with an area over 10 lakh square kilometer. Egypt situated at the meeting point of Africa and Asia. It is called the gift of Nile because without the Nile, Egypt would have remained desert. The Nile brings water and fine fertile silt from the equatorial regions of Africa to the desert. This has made Egypt the grandeur of ancient world. Huge pyramids, sculptures, temples and the inscriptions in these temples tells us a lot about Egyptian culture and history. The Egyptians were expert farmers. They knew a lot about irrigation. They had built temples. They invented the calendar, which has helped us to measure time. They had mastered the art of writing. It was a symbolic language, so it consists of small drawings and has been called hieroglyphics. The Nile Valley. Every rainy season, the Nile River would transform the Nile Valley into a huge lake. After the valley dried up in summer, a fertile layer of clay soil would form the grazing field and neighboring agriculture lands. The work that would need the labor of hundreds of people was being done by the kind river all alone. This fertile land provided food for the population of the first town in the area. Not all agricultural regions were in the valley, hence through small canals and wells, they were responsible for the development of complex system of irrigation throughout the land. The prosperous, wealthy Egyptian peasants and citizens during their leisure engaged themselves in the creation of artistic works. The role of priest was created to interpret nature and explain it. The priests were scholars and shouldered the responsibility of protecting written documents. They believed in life after death. They believed that the man had to give an account of his deeds on earth to Osiris, the most powerful god of life and death. The priest considered that life on earth was temporary and was needed only to prepare for the next life. Thus, the whole of the Nile Valley was reserved for the dead. The dead body would be smeared with various chemicals and wrapped with a thin cloth. The entire body was in this way preserved. The body protected was called a mummy. It would be kept in a specially designed coffin. The grave was considered the true place for an Egyptian. Hence, all around the dead body, items needed for daily use and small dolls of a cook and barber would be kept to fulfill all future needs. In the beginning, graves were created by carving into the rocks in the hills. As the Egyptians moved north, they had to construct graves in the desert itself. Tall towers were built on these graves using huge blocks of stone in order to protect the eternal sleep of the dead. Kings and wealthy people vied with each other to build taller and taller towers. The Greeks called these structures pyramids. The kings of Egypt were called pharaohs. Pharaoh means a person who lives in a palatial house. The peasants who had accepted the rule of powerful Osiris now accepted the rule of pharaohs too. After an independent, prosperous life for 20 centuries, Egypt was ruled over by an Arabian shepherd tribe
called Hyksos, which attacked it and after defeating it, ruled for 500 years. They looted the wealth of the natives and hence did not become popular. So, the Jews who came wandering through the deserts in search of shelter were also hated by the people of Egypt. By cooperating with the foreign rule, the Jews assisted them in collecting taxes and in administration. In 1700 BCE, the people of Thebes rose in revolt against the foreigners. After a conflict, they succeeded in driving Hyksos out of their country. Egypt became free once again. After 1,000 years, it came under the rule of Sardanapalus of Assyria. The Persian Emperor Cambyses occupied Egypt in 6th century BCE. Then, Alexander, a Greek king, by defeating Persian king Darius III, occupied Persia in 4th century BCE. Then, Egypt became a province of Macedonia. Macedonia, it is a state of Greek. Then, Alexander's military general Ptolemy declared himself the king of Egypt and established the dynasty of Ptolemy. He founded the city of Alexandria. At last came the Romans in 39 BCE. The last Egyptian queen, Cleopatra, tried her best to save her country. It was said that the Romans feared her beauty more than her troops. Twice she was successful in her attack upon the hearts of the Roman conquerors. So, in 30 BCE, Julius Caesar's successor and his son-in-law Augustus did not resist to her beauty like his father-in-law, but defeated her army, though he spared her life when he planned to carry her away along with other spoils of the battle. Cleopatra consumed poison and ended her life. From then onwards, Egypt became a province of Rome. So students, today we had learned Egypt civilization. In next session, we will learn Mesopotamian and Chinese civilization.